Rest the multiply. Notice each product involves decimals. So for part A, we have 0.4 times 0.7. Let's first write this product vertically. So again, we have 0.4 times 0.7. The next step is to determine the number of decimal places in each of these decimals. Well, notice that 0.4 has one decimal place, and so does 0.7. So again, 0.4 has one decimal place, and 0.7 also has one decimal place. And now to find the number of decimal places in the product, we need to sum these decimal places, and because 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, we now know the product must contain two decimal places. Next, we're going to multiply as if we had whole numbers and not decimals. 4 times 7 is equal to 28. So for the number 28, the decimal point would be to the right of the 8 here. But because we now know we need two decimal places, we need to move the decimal point to the left two places. So 1, 2. So our product is 0.28. But often, we'll place a 0 in the ones place value and read their product as 0.28. So we now know that 0.4 times 0.7 equals 0.28. But let's explain why we need two decimal places. 0.4 is 4 tenths, so as a fraction we would have 4 over 10. And 0.7 is 7 tenths, as a fraction that would be 7 over 10. So this product must be equal to 0.28. So if we multiply, 4 times 7 is 28, 10 times 10 equals 100. So the product is 28 hundredths, which we do have expressed correctly as a decimal. 0.28 is 28 hundredths. Of course, as a fraction, we need to simplify, but here we're multiplying decimals. Let's look at part B. We have 0.06 times 0.9. Again, let's write this vertically. So we have 0.06 times 0.9. We begin by determining the number of decimal places in these decimals. So 0.06 has two decimal places, and 0.9 has one decimal place. So again, here we have two decimal places, and here we have one decimal place. We sum these decimal places to determine the number of decimal places in the product. Well, 2 plus 1 is equal to 3, and therefore the product must contain 3 decimal places. Next, we multiply as if we had whole numbers. Well, 6 times 9 is equal to 54. For 54, the decimal point would be to the right of the 4, which would be here. But because we need 3 decimal places, we need to move the decimal point to the left 3 places. So 1, 2. For missing digits, we have the digit of 0. So we'll add a 0 here, so we can actually move 3 decimal places to the left. So the product is 0.054, more often given as 0.054. So now we know that 0.06 times 0.9 equals 0.054. Again, to understand why we need 3 decimal places, 0.06 is 6 hundredths, 0.9 is 9 tenths. Multiplying in fraction form, 6 times 9 equals 54, and 100 times 10 is equal to 1,000. The product is 54 thousandths, which as a decimal is 0.054. Let's look at one more example. We have 0.74 times 0.05. Let's write this product vertically. Zero point seven four has two decimal places, and so does 0.05. So we have two decimal places here, two decimal places here. And because 2 plus 2 is equal to 4, the product must contain 4 decimal places. Now we multiply as if we had whole numbers. 5 times 4 is equal to 20, so we have a 0 here, perform an exchange with the 2. 5 times 7 is 35 plus 2, which equals 37. So for 74 times 5, the product is 370, and the decimal point would be to the right of the zero here. Because we need four decimal places, we move the decimal point to the right four times. So 1, 2, 3. Let's go ahead and add two zeros on the left. Again, we need four decimal places, so we need to move one more decimal place to here. So the product is 0.0370, but we can actually drop this zero here and write this as just 0.037. So 0.74 times 0.05 equals 0.037. To explain why this product makes sense, let's show the product as fractions. 0.74 is 74 hundredths, so we have 74 hundredths times 0.05 is 5 hundredths. If we multiply, we know that 75 times 5 is 370, and we know that 100 times 100 is equal to 10,000. Notice how the original decimal was 370 ten thousandths, but because the numerator and denominator share a common factor of 10, notice how if we divide the numerator and denominator by 10, we would have 37 over 1,000, or 37 thousandths, which is what we have here as our final product in decimal form. 0.037 is 37 thousandths. So if we have any zeros on the far right of our decimal, we can leave the zeros off without changing the value of the decimal. I hope you found this helpful.